Okay, let us figure out how to debunk modern physics in just 10 minutes. First, you need to understand how Einstein's theory of special relativity is wrong, because that allows you to gain back the medium for the electromagnetic wave theory. In his paper, he writes that the introduction of a light ether or light medium will not be necessary. Now let's take a look at the illogic built into this theory. Einstein's relativity tells us that when you are moving, your time moves slower relative to someone else that is at rest. In this illustration, time is moving slower for the people that are moving in this car. In Einstein relativity, you can reverse this process and say that the car is at rest. So both of these scenarios are completely valid. Even though this scenario here might seem weird to us, but we can imagine the person on the side of the road zipping by us at 60 miles an hour while we are at rest inside of the car. The paradox arises because each scenario has a different person moving and the moving clock slows. That's illogical. You can't have both scenarios be valid, and in both scenarios, you have slowing clocks. If you still don't think this is a problem, or just a simple disagreement on whose clock is slower, then you are actually disagreeing with what Albert Einstein says himself. On the second page of this paper, he describes the clock paradox that we just talked about. He says, "Even the devoutest adherents of the theory cannot claim that of two clocks resting side by side, each one is slow relative to the other." Now, notice he tries to wiggle his way out with this little phrase. So the clock paradox itself does not prove the theory wrong. It just shows us that there is illogic built in and there's something wrong somewhere. The spherical wave proof is what completely invalidates Einstein's entire paper. In this other video that I made, I wrote a program to calculate the formulas based on section 3 of his paper. The spherical wave proof failed, and I put the source code to the program that I wrote in the description of that video. Anyone can give it a try. Now we'll move on to quantum mechanics. What's real crazy here is that quantum mechanics hinges on one man's belief system and this footnote in his paper. So getting rid of quantum mechanics will get back the real meaning to Schrödinger's classical wave equation. These three bullets describe how quantum mechanics screwed up Schrödinger's wave equation. Schrödinger's wave equation has nothing to do with particles, and the meaning of Schrödinger's equation was hijacked by Max Born and quantum mechanics. Schrödinger's equation describes wave systems. So let's look at a conceptual demonstration of that. Let's collide two waves together, and you can think of these as waves of water. Schrödinger's equation is designed to describe these types of systems. As these waves collide with each other, their amplitudes will add together into what's called a wave superposition. This is a very natural thing that you can see on any lake when boat wakes collide. In fact, professional wakeboarders use this technique in their contests, and it's called a double up. Wave superposition is a real tangible thing. And then we can move this forward, and the waves will continue on. So back to Max Born. This is the paper where he forced the idea of quantum particles into Schrödinger's wave equation. Max tells us right here that in collisions, one deals not with mysterious wave fields, but exclusively with systems of material particles subject to the formalism of quantum mechanics. So if you're going to fit the idea of quantum material particles into the Schrödinger wave equation, only one interpretation is possible: the probability. And don't forget the footnote that tells you have to multiply these wave equation answers together in order to not have negative probabilities. And then one last opinion from Max Born. It says, "I myself am inclined to give up determinism in the world of atoms. So this is where indeterminism and probabilities originate for quantum mechanics. Let's demonstrate Max Born's idea. This is still the same Schrödinger wave equation here, but instead of waves colliding, we have to imagine that these are material particles. So let's say we have two electrons coming together at this point in time. Now, how do you explain two material particles occupying the same space? It's not logically possible, and this is exactly what Schrödinger's cat is making fun of. Because now you have to consider probabilities of finding the particle. And you have to make up a name for this wave superposition and call it a quantum state superposition. And this idea is what quantum computers are also relying on. And unfortunately, it's not a real thing. The quantum bit is based on quantum state superposition. And if you want to understand more of the problems with quantum computers, you can watch my video. Next is the photon particle. One of the big problems with the photon is that there is no definition for a single photon. If you use the equation E equals HF, that is a 1 second wave energy equation. For example, I use a 3 Hz frequency and you can see 3 different waves within 1 second. So F in this equation would be 3. Then you can see 3 H's, one for each wave. This is not an equation for a particle. It is an energy equation for 1 second worth of waves. For more details on the problems with the photon particle, wave-particle duality, and the double-slit experiment, you can go ahead and watch this video. And finally, the electron particle as it applies to electron theory of electricity. The problem with electron theory is it cannot properly describe how a capacitor works. Modern physics says that the electrons on the plates of the capacitor do all the work. So the electrons on the plates create an electric field that polarizes the dielectric or plastic piece in the capacitor. This can't be true because in a dissectable capacitor, you can remove that plastic piece or the dielectric and discharge it without being in the field that they say is created by the electrons. For more information on this issue and to see the lab experiments that I did, you can watch my video. So if the charge is stored in the dielectric of a capacitor, then you gain back an interesting idea of Maxwell's dielectric displacement of the ether. Think about a capacitor that uses the vacuum as a dielectric. Okay, so now where do we go since we've eliminated a bunch of physics? Electromagnetics, optics, the wave theory is again waving a medium. Schrödinger's wave equation is again waving a medium. And yes, as he designed, in his papers, he talks about the ether. And he is using Maxwell-Lorentz electrodynamics, not Einstein. Since the electron theory cannot properly explain a capacitor, the material point electron gives up its charge and allows us to put charge back into the medium. So all of this brings us back to the Maxwell-Heaviside ideas of electromagnetism, which includes dielectric dynamics and dielectric energy. And one more possible point here is to classically integrate Planck's constant of energy into electromagnetism. Now, if that doesn't make any sense, I have another video you can watch to get more details on the origin of Planck's constant and what went wrong there. And so the main point here is to try to minimize belief in illogical science. Okay, that is it for this video. Thanks, everybody.